Hello, I'm Bill Gustaw, Team Leader for the Solutions Group at CMIC. Thank you for your interest in CMIC's resource planning application. You know, a major challenge for organizations is figuring out how to access and visualize project resource plans all in one place. CMIC Resource Planning pulls all the information for each project together into a simple, user-friendly interface. All you need to do is check the board to see a visual status for the entire company. CMIC Resource Planning is fully integrated with other CMIC applications, for example, CRM, project management, equipment management, payroll, and talent management. Resource Planning has two views. What you're looking at right now is the summary view. There is also a detail view. So the first question is, how do all these records get into resource planning? Well, there's a number of ways that that can happen. If you are using CMIC's CRM application, we can start to assign resources to an opportunity that we're pursuing, either individually, or I may choose to create a template that represents the different styles of projects that we do, data center projects, interiors, infrastructure, etc. If we've won the opportunity, I have the same capability on the project in CMIC's project management application. I also have the flexibility to assign resources on the fly as situation and changes occur on a project-by-project basis. So let's start by taking a look at the detail view. Now, there's two sections to this screen. The upper portion are the needs that we have, either for opportunities or projects, and the bottom portion represents the resources that we have to fill those needs. I have the ability to resize the view that I'm seeing on the screen, either by dragging and dropping either up or down, or left and right, depending on what I need to look at or focus in at this particular point in time. I also have the ability to change my time dimension. So right now, I'm looking at things on a weekly view, rolling up to a monthly view. And if I wanted to change that, I can do that by going under preferences and changing my time scale. Whatever scale I select here will become the bottom row, and then the system will automatically roll it up to the next time scale in the upper row. In terms of planning my resources, I have the ability to either soft or hard my resources depending on where I am in terms of the planning process. If I wanted to lock something in place, I can go ahead and hard allocate it. I can also have control over the percentage allocation to that particular project for that resource. You'll also notice that we distinguish both the opportunities and the projects by the icons that you see down the left-hand side. The yellow icons represent opportunities, the blue icons represent projects. So I can choose to look at everything that I'm seeing here, or I can choose to look at it on a project-by-project basis. And again, I can do that in one of two ways. I can use the filters that you see in the upper portion of the screen, or I can choose under the preferences to display the summary rows, and then from there I can then focus my attention on one particular project. So if I wanted to expand the NFL stadium project, all I simply need to do is click here, and then I can see the requirements that I have for that particular project. So I have the ability to filter both in terms of the needs and a planning process, either look at things on a company by company basis or holistically for all the companies in my organization. I can be the master scheduler for all resources across the board, or I may be a scheduler that works in a particular division or a particular regional office. I also have the ability from a resource perspective to include not only existing employees that we have set up in payroll, but I may choose to include applicants that we have in CMIC's talent management module by turning on the flag that you see here. So I have a lot of freedom and a lot of flexibility in tailoring or fine-tuning exactly what I'm looking at in this particular view of the information. So how does somebody actually work with this? Well, let's use this as an example. I have a need for a project manager. When I click on this line, it opens up the fields here, and then down below, I see all of the resources that I have available in terms of project managers to fill this particular need. Now, it's possible that all of my project managers are 100% allocated to existing projects, and I can fine-tune that again by turning on the available only flag, or if I am faced with a situation like that, maybe I have, for the time being, I may not have a senior project manager available to me, but maybe I have an assistant or a junior project manager available, and they potentially could step in and fill the gap for the first couple weeks of the project. So I have that freedom as well. Furthermore, it may not be enough to say I need a project manager with a particular set of skills. I can use the search button to say, okay, I need a project manager who has data center experience, or somebody who's got commercial building experience, or somebody that has a hazmat certification, or lives within a certain distance of the project, or has worked with this client in the past. All of these criteria that you see here, a lot of them are attached to the employee record and payroll, and I have the ability to go ahead, make my selections, and once again, if this is a repeatable exercise that you're doing, I can save that as a template, but then I can go ahead and hit the search button, and that will then give me a list of all of the project managers available, but the ones that only match the particular set of skills or criteria that I've selected on this particular search. And then having done that, I have the ability to make my selection and drop that individual into this particular requirement. You'll also notice from a scheduling perspective that I can see both sides of the equation. I can see things from a project perspective, and I can also see things from a resource perspective. So if I wanted to know, for example, what projects Jeff Tennis is working on during a particular time frame, I can see that right here, or I could possibly filter on a particular resource and see what they're actually working on and what length of time they're going to be assigned to that particular project. When I want to make my assignments, I have a couple ways that I can do that. And I'm going to use Yves LaRocque as an example. I can double-click on the icon, and that would take Yves LaRocque and slot him into this particular assignment, or I can just simply grab that record and do a drag and drop, and that would assign this particular employee to that particular resource. I may choose to further refine this as well, or if I decide to proceed with this, I can change the allocation from hard to soft, or soft to hard rather, and I can change the percentage allocation. So these are all of the options you have available to you from a detailed perspective in fine-tuning and planning the resources that you have, where they're going to be, how long they're going to be there, and when they're going to be available to be assigned to something else. Okay? Now, I have the option based on my security. I can toggle from the detail view to the summary view, or maybe I'm starting in the summary view and I want to drill into the detail view. So when we take a look at the summary perspective, you'll notice there's a legend in the bottom left-hand corner that explains the color coding that you're seeing here. The green bars that you see represent a need that we have, and we have a resource assigned to that need. The blue bars represent a need, and we don't actually have anybody slotted into that particular requirement. Where you're starting to see potential problems are the yellow bars and the red bars. The yellow bars indicate that I have people with a particular set of skills and I have no requirements or needs to assign them to, and the red bars represent a situation where I have more needs than I have people. So I do have the ability to either drill into the details by either clicking on the resource type here, or if I wanted to focus on a particular time, I can take a look and double click on one of the bars during a particular time slot and drill into the details that way as well. And you can see that I've moved from the summary view into the detail view. Okay. So if we spend a little bit more time here, let's take a look at some of the information. Now, I mentioned earlier that we are fully integrated with payroll. So in our payroll application, you may have many different resources or trades set up in payroll, and not all of them may be relevant when it comes to resource planning. So in the utilities menu, I do have the option to go ahead and determine which trades are going to be visible or available in the resource planning application. And all it is, you're not doing any extra work. All it is simply going in and turning on the flag that you see here to determine which resources are going to be visible and available from the resource planning application. So everything we've talked about so far has been focused on the labor component. I also have the same capability when it comes to equipment. If we are using our equipment management application, I have the ability to do exactly the same thing when it comes to the equipment. And as you can see here, just by changing the radio buttons, I have the ability to do both labor and equipment all at the same time. Okay. Some of the other things that I can do, of course, is I can make adjustments on the fly. As I mentioned earlier, resources can be assigned here either from the project or the opportunity, or if I use the utilities option, there are a number of things that I can do here. I can add additional needs to a project on the fly. I can remove needs if the situation on a project changes, and I have the ability to directly go into the maintenance screen for projects, opportunities, trades, and equipment as well. I can go ahead and change the start and end date for a required resource. And one of the things that is also very, very handy is if I take a resource and I assign that resource to a particular need, and I say, well, okay, that's good. I'm going to go ahead and move forward and hard allocate that. When I try and save what I've just done here, the system will warn me and I will get a pop-up that says, this individual is already over capacity. What you're trying to do here, you can't do that because they're over 100% allocated. So you're going to have to make a decision and either change the resource or maybe redistribute the way that you've done the allocation. So just to wrap up and summarize, from a corporate perspective, you have the ability to view your resources, either labor or equipment, view the needs that you have, the people that you have, or the equipment that you have to fill those needs, view it from a detailed perspective, view it from an overall holistic company view, and this gives you the, as I said at the outset, that one-stop shop, the dashboard, where you can plan and manage your resources at a corporate level. Thank you very much for your time.